wherever you are, wherever you're watching us from, you're welcome to Beacon Life Church, Nairobi, Kenya. We are committed to shining Jesus' light as we advance the glorious gospel of the kingdom. Our services are on Sunday, 10 a.m., Power Thursday, which is also our midweek prayer service at 6 p.m. You're welcome to log into our life groups, Beacon at Home, Beacon at Work. Don't you hesitate to get in touch with us for the details of the life group that is closest to you. Feel excited to join us on our social media handles to subscribe, like, comment, and follow Beacon Life Church on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Let's now celebrate the Lord with our generous giving. The M-Pesa paybill number is 535471. You can also give through PayPal by following the link on our website, www.beaconlifechurch.org. For cash, checks, and transfers, our bank details are displayed on the screen. Thanks a bunch for joining us today. Welcome to Beacon Life Church. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the service.
I want to very, very deeply appreciate everybody that has been here. I know all the young men have been here working very powerfully during the week. We start very early, would go till late. I think last night we were leaving here almost 9 p.m. And I want to very deeply appreciate everybody that has put their sacrifice, their giving, their money, their energy, their prayers, to what is happening here and to what has happened so far. Amen. Be encouraged to continue to give, even if you've already given before, even if you've made your pledge. If you made your pledge and you've not honored it yet, this would be a very, very good week because we need it very desperately and urgently. And we trust that the Lord will use you and use everybody of us to be a part of that in Jesus' mighty name. All right. If you haven't made a pledge, this would be a good time to do that. Let's give and give and give and give. We can't outgive God. And if you go out of your way to sacrifice for the Lord, He's sure will return to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. In Jesus' mighty name. I want us to go to the scriptures quickly. I think about 20 minutes that I have. I'm going to read for you from Matthew chapter number 14. Make a few highlights off of that. We'll receive our offering and we'll share the words of the grace. So Matthew chapter number 14. And I'm going to read verse number 26. It's a famous story that you know. You can just follow with me as I read quickly for the sake of time. He says in verse number 26, "And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, 'It is a spirit,'" or in other words, "it is a ghost. And they cried out for fear." Verse number 27, "But straightway Jesus spake unto them, saying, 'Be of good cheer, it is I.'" Look at your neighbor and say, "Be of good cheer." Talk boldly, say, "Be of good cheer, it is I. Be not afraid." 28, "And Peter answered him and said, 'Lord, if it be thou, bid me to come unto thee on the water.'" 29, "And he said, 'Come.'" Now say together with me, "Come." "And when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But when he saw the wind boisterous, he was afraid. And beginning to sink, he cried, saying, 'Lord, save me.' Immediately Jesus stretched forth his hand and caught him. And he said unto him, 'O thou of little faith, wherefore didst thou doubt? Wherefore didst thou doubt?'" We thank you for your word and we count it blessed. May that blessing flow in our spirits and in our hearts this morning in Jesus' name. This text is used very strongly usually to talk about the doctrine and the idea and the ideology of faith. It's a powerful explanation of faith in our hearts, and we could spend probably 3-4 days in there talking about the many, many nuggets in there. I wouldn't do today in the few minutes that I have, but I want to use it to share with you the concept on my heart that I call the call of faith. The call of faith. God is always calling us out by faith to be able to accomplish His plan, to be able to bring to pass His desire. You will never be able to do what God wants you to do if you don't have the capacity, innate capacity on the inside of you to step out on the water by faith and be able to do what God asks you to do. They see Jesus, they think He's a ghost. But he tells them, be of good cheer, don't be afraid, it is I. And I wonder how many times in your life you're in a state where you feel like you're surrounded by the devil, and you look around and it feels like there are all manner of spirits around you, anxiety and all manner of fear. It looks like you are in the darkest hour of your life, the midnight hour of your life. The winds are raging and you look at the sea and it looks like a spirit coming to torment you. It looks like a devil coming to overwhelm you. And yet Jesus says, do not be afraid, be of good cheer, it is I. I hope that's a prophetic word for somebody already, because it is the Lord in the midst of your tragedies. It is the Lord in the midst of your struggles. It is the Lord in the midst of your tears. It is the Lord in the midst of your anxieties, and is there to declare, don't you be afraid, it is I. I am in charge of this situation and I will take care of it. I am the Lord God of your life. I am the Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and as I did in their lives, so shall I do in your own life. Peter says, well, Lord, if it is you, I guess he's asking out of doubt, because he cannot believe that could be his Lord looking like that. He says, if it is you, bid me to come. And one thing Jesus says, did you hear it? He says, come. I want you to say together with me, come. That's the call of faith, because God is calling you and me every time to step out on the water, every time to do something impossible, every time to do something beyond your imagination. God is calling out every time that you may be able to step out. He says, come. I know it is the water, you've never walked on the water before, but I say come. I know it is fearful and it looks dark and the money is not there and the logistics are not there, but I say come, because it doesn't take the money to do what you think it takes to do. It takes the presence of God with you. It takes the voice of God with you. It takes a response to his call. When you step in the water, I don't know the chemistry, the physics, and the biology, but the water will respond that you will not sink. I know the water is boisterous, and I know it looks like you're going to sink and get overwhelmed, but Jesus says, come. Question here today, are you going to listen to the voice of the water, the boisterous water, the winds, and the fears of your life, or you are going to hear the call of faith that is asking you to come? As a ministry, God has been calling us for many years. And every time God calls, we step into the unknown and trust God that we'll be able to do the impossible, not by power, not by might, but by his spirit. We are here today under an open heaven in this dedication service. As we sit here, I know the sun is scorching, but this is a sign of faith, because God says, come. Glory to God. I thought we'd stay at home and have an online service, but I could hear the voice of God say, come. And in your life is calling, in your business dreams is calling, in the passions of your life, God is calling. Whatever you think God is asking you to do, he has already declared by faith, you come. And you need to respond to that come. Get your foot out of your comfort zone and step in the place where God is. Every time God says come, our heart is shaken with a coulda, woulda, shoulda. I hope you know that what that means. Could I? Should I? Would I? Will I? You are always asking, and that is the sample of the doubt in your heart. I want you to ignore the doubt in your heart. Lenga iyo shaka kabisa, and listen to the voice of God that you will step in there when he says come. Forget your shoulda, coulda, woulda, and step into the place that God is asking you to go, because he will be with you. He will walk with you. The call of faith is not a realm of comfort. It's not a realm of convenience. It is a realm of conscience, and it is a realm of conviction. When God calls you, he calls you out of your comfort. He calls you out of your comfort zone. He calls you out of your comfort place. He calls you out of your bed, out of your sofa, out of your lazy boy chair. God is always calling you out of the places you're used to. He called Abraham out of the place of his father and of his family. He always calls you out of the places where you have been, because he wants to take you to a place you've never been before. And he told Abraham, I will show you the place where you should go. I know you are used to your fathers. I know you are used to your family. I know you are used to the kind of business you're doing. I know you're used to the kind of money and salary you're operating. But God is saying, come. Because if you come, I'm going to take you to a place you've never seen before. I know it, and I will show you that place. We can only step into that place if we deny ourselves the comfort of yesterday, if we deny ourselves our abilities of yesterday. We must say no to the tent of yesterday, so that we can press forward yet to another level. Somebody say hallelujah. It's been a while in your life, and there are areas where you are so comfortable, you like to do it that way, and you don't think anything will ever change or could ever change. God is saying, come out of your comfort into the discomfort, because when you get to the place of discomfort by faith, God will be there to comfort you yet again. God will be there there to comfort you yet again. If you're so comfortable now, God has no reason to be comforting you where you are right now. But you step into the waters. Glory to God. Do you know that Peter did not sink? When he looked at the wind, boisterous, he began to sink. The Lord pulled him up. Oh, ye of little faith, why did you doubt? They walked back to the boat together. In other words, Peter got the experience that none of the disciples ever got to have in their 3 years of walk with Jesus, because he had the courage to respond to the call of faith and to be able to walk with God, even if it is a moment with Jesus, walking in response to the call of faith. It will always be a making of a history. Out of your comfort into discomfort, so that God will have divine opportunity to comfort you yet again. If I'm talking, somebody say hallelujah. So if you're comfortable as a fisherman, he will give you a call of faith and say, follow me, because I will make you fishers of men. If you're comfortable with your little fish and bread as lunch for one little boy, he will say, begin to give to the multitude. Somebody say hallelujah. He says, give to the people, let them eat. Hallelujah. If you've been laying in your bed for years, when you meet with Jesus, he will say, carry your bed and go home, because he's shaking you out of your discomfort as he calls you into yet a new level of comfort in your life. If your hand has been withered for a very long time, when you meet with Jesus, he doesn't say, sorry, be comfortable with your withered hand. He says, stretch it out, because he's calling you by faith into yet another place of discomfort, which is going to be the manifestation of a miracle you probably have never dreamt or imagined. I see the leprous man meet with Jesus. You know what he tells them? He doesn't tell them, stay away because you're unclean. He gives them a call of faith. He said, go show yourself to the high priest, because that is a work of a miracle in progress in your life. If you are maimed, he will say, stand up and walk. If you don't know what to say, he'll say, go and speak to them. I will put my words in your mouth, and nobody will be able to gainsay or even resist. Somebody say hallelujah. So faith calls you out of the known into the unknown. Faith calls you out of the comfort into the discomfort. And I want to add something in there and say that faith always calls you into the boisterous environment where the winds are shaking, where you don't seem to have the money to do what you got to do, where you don't seem to have the friends and capacity to do. They tell you about capacity building, and you need 3 years to build capacity so that you can be able to handle that assignment. God will call you without capacity, and if you respond to that call by faith, you'll see the miracle of God making your feet like hinds' feet, that by the grace of God you will be able to walk in the high places of the calling of God upon your life. Somebody say hallelujah. So you will conquer every boisterous environment in your life, and the winds will come down, and the storm will break, and the waters will feel your presence, that a man of God is walking in the realm of impossibilities. Glory to God. Let me conclude with the idea. Bible says that you will never be tempted beyond measure, because God will always put a way of escape for you. I'd like to say that the call of faith calls you to a place that is beyond measure. Why does God not tempt you beyond measure, and yet he calls you by faith into a place that is beyond what you can bear? Do you know why? Ask me why, and I will say, I'm so glad you asked. He gives you more than you can bear, because he knows he's going to bear it for you. Are you listening to me? Like a man in the gym pushing the weights. I like working out with my big built up bodies in the gym, because as you push it, after pushing the first set, the second set, you can't go to 10, because at 5 you feel like you can't push anymore. Then there is a guy at the back here standing behind you who puts a little bit of his hand, just a little finger, and he begin to bear it for you. And when you reach 3 reps and you're done your 12 reps in 3 sets, he lifts the weight off of you and puts it down. Then you get off that bench feeling like a conqueror, feeling like a mighty guy, like a mighty man doing some mighty things. And yet there was a big bourgeois here that has been doing the work for you as you build your capacity. Such is God, that is calling you into a space of what is more than what you can bear, because he's assured that he will bear it for you. He will not wait that weight come on you and crumble your life. He calls you to do things whose bills you cannot pay, because he knows he will pay the bills for you. He calls you into places that are larger than life, because he knows that he will do for you what you cannot do for yourself. I say hallelujah. He always calls you into a place of great risk, and yet if you respond to faith in God, your risk is actually no risk at all. Ultimately, the call of faith is always a call to to his glory. When we are done with all that we do on this side of eternity, and we walked our journey with him, we've built the churches, we've laid people to the Lord, we've healed the sick, we've spent all the money in our generation, we've harvested souls, we've taught the children, we've blessed the nations, after we've done all there is to do, all of that, ladies and gentlemen, is to the glory of God. That's why your greatest rank will be, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant," because everything you did on this side of eternity as a servant of God, it was for his glory, it was for his honor, and it was for his beauty. This that we are doing here is not for my glory, it's not for the glory of Pastor Lucy here, it is for the glory of God. I say hallelujah, I say hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. The lands we buy, the buildings we will build, the projects we will do, it is all for the glory of God. I think I should pause right there and testify a little bit. Our leaders know since last night that yesterday, for the first time, our titles in Konza have finally appeared, written the name Beacon Life Church. I said that that is a first fruit of much that yet God is going to do in terms of possession of capital, assets, and buildings in the city, the nation, and around the world. That is a first fruit. Glory to God. Somebody say hallelujah. And it is not to the glory of man, but to the glory of God. And what God has begun to do, nobody, no man, no devil in hell, or man on earth, or even angel in heaven will be able to stop it. Isn't it interesting that the week we strip down the tent and begin to do something like this is the same week that those titles yield? Now, it could be a coincidence, but those of us that are prophetic, we know that there is nothing coincidental about that. It is the voice of God. It is the unction of the Holy Spirit. It is a sign from above that what he has begun to do in our midst, it's at the threshold of manifestation. If you believe with me and responding to the call of faith, lift your right hand of power and say, "Yes, I believe it, I receive it, and I walk in the fullness of it by the power of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' mighty name." Put your hands together. Let's give him a praise. I did so well. I have 6 minutes. We'll use that to dedicate the sanctuary. So I'm going to ask you to stand up on your feet in Jesus' name. Nazi and your team, you can come back here. Let's play a little jazz to the Lord as we pour oil on the ground in the mighty name of Jesus.